in the early 50s or late 50s. Yung mga mafia na nandun sila sa Las Vegas at hindi nila magbuwa na itong gusto nila. So, nandisprove nila may bayan na 70 miles away from the United States in Florida. At nakita na ito ay mabait na bansa. Itong gobyerno nito ay viable, hindi viable, viable. Yung panahon ni Batista doon. Papasukan natin yan na tinatawag natin mga kasino. At kaya natin bilhin ang mga tao doon, at kaya natin magliwaliw doon, gawin natin kung ano ang gusto natin, at yun nga ang nangyari. Mabuti na marunong ang Diyos, natanggal si Batista at napumasok si Castro. Kaya dapat tignan natin yung mga napapag-aralan natin sa ibang bansa sapagkat hindi naman talaga.
Right? For this declaration. And another one, Simon Rodriguez for $700,000. That was not properly declared. So you're only conducting the investigation in February. That was 2019.
Mr. Chair, if I may, we only received the referral from the AMLC in January of 2020. That's why we prompted.
Is the mail that slow?
Meaning we got the referral from AMLC only in January
2020. So, did AMLAS sit down on this? You got a letter. Central Bank got the letter on the same day. Can you please show the letter? This is the one from Bureau of Customs to Governor Diokno. There, no, Diokno. And then another letter that was sent to BIR. Show the letter, please.
Of course, we have the suggestion.
That's the first good judgment you've made today. Let's talk about the other judgment you're about to make. Do you agree with that? One month and 10 days, do you know, Raman, I drink in the letter October 9th. Could have been saying that. Action target. Kulihin niya. Now, you talk about it's beyond their capacity, beyond their permit, di ba? That is section 3 of their suspicious circumstances. The amount involved is not to measure it with the business or financial capacity of the client. Are you referring to that, ma'am?
Yes, Mr.
Chair. Under suspicious circumstances, right? So, wouldn't you say that the continuous unabated entry of millions and millions and millions of dollars like a parade on Independence Day, walang tigil, pumapasok, wouldn't that be suspicious, sir?
Any authority to arrest them or seize the public citizen of the Philippines, sir, here, they are not the subject of further investigation, sir. For us to be able to look for other violations that they may have committed for us to be able to
investigate. Regulations of individuals, Mr. Chair. The top currencies are US dollars. Approximately around $336 million came in 2019. Japanese yen is around $2,749,000,000. For Hong Kong dollars, approximately $215 million.
Okay, just so we can fully appreciate it. Yes, sir, these are based on documents. How much would that be?
For the entire year, 2019.
Yes, okay, for 1 year. Let's say, okay, see, 2019, say what? 2019, how much? So that we will know what we're talking about here.
Parameters.
The parameters.
What is wrong? We just shocked.
Yes, Mr. Chair, if I may be allowed to comment on the presumption that this is a laundered funds. It's basic under the civil code that good faith is always presumed. So whenever they declare this, and the declaration says the sources of funds is business, forex, savings, etc. And that's why the suspicious circumstance arose, and then we investigated and we gathered facts. Requested information from jurisdictions where these passengers came from, and they returned to us. They don't have any total information. Unlike that, the setup or legal framework in the U.S., where they have an anti-bad cash smuggling law, they reverse the presumption, the burden of proof. Under that law, the passengers who carry the bulk cash has the burden to prove that the source of funds is legitimate. Under our framework, that does not exist, Mr. Chair, because of that.
I disagree.
Yeah. I disagree also, Mr. Chair.
No comment. Do you agree?
Yeah. No, you know, that's on that point, sir. You know, that is why we have a suspicious transaction provision in our anti-money laundering counter. And what is that? Transactions which are unusual and cannot be supported by the ordinary course of the business. For example, if I deposit 1 million pesos in a bank, they'll ask me saan galing yan kasi wala naman akong negosyo that will generate 1 million pesos. On the other hand, if San Miguel deposits that, no question asked. In other words, the issue of knowing your customer or client is precisely the reason why at a certain level it becomes a suspicious transaction. Kaya po hindi ako naniniwala na our law does not provide for that. But having said that, you know, all these things happened recently. Since the POGO came into our shores, all these things suddenly happened. Now, you know, I am disappointed, for the record, at the statement today of PAC4 saying that we are in favor of POGO continuing in our shores because of the income we earn. Such a short-term, short-range statement. The social problems, Mr. Sevilla, that POGO has brought to our country, is not worth the regulation fees that you earn from POGO. Let me tell you that right in your face. For 8 billion pesos as fees that you get, you're saying that they should be here? You heard, you saw what happened in Punti in National Village? You saw what this prostitution rings have happened, and these are all connected to POGO. You know, that statement, I must say, is such a stupid statement that indicates the kind of mindset we have. Basta pera ko baso kahit na lahat ay magiging, we can tolerate all these things now.